Our next guests have worked closely with federal policymakers on early education and are here to give us some insight into the initiatives we could see from President-elect Obama and the 111th Congress. Kathy Patterson, federal policy director with Pre-K Now, joins us, as does Nina Reese with Knowledge Universe Education, and formerly the Assistant Deputy Secretary for Innovation and Improvement at the Department of Education. We also have David Kerp, public policy professor from the University of California at Berkeley. David, what major early education proposals might we expect from President Obama?
Well, I think President Obama is the first early education president. He really gets it, I think, partly because he has young daughters himself, and partly because he comes from a state, Illinois, which has great programs. But he really has outlined a vision of a zero, really before zero, sort of pregnant mother at an age five program, which is high quality, seamless. We get rid of the separate program silos and try to bring things together. Well coordinated and well evaluated. The hope really is to produce the kind of program that any parent would want for his or her child.
Nina, given your experience at the Department of Education, what barriers are waiting out there for the proposals David mentioned and others from the new administration?
Sure. Let me first start by commending the president-elect and his team's commitment to early childhood education. David is right in a sense that this is the first time a presidential candidate has brought this much attention on a comprehensive zero to five agenda. And for that reason alone, we're extremely excited. Our company is very excited about the opportunities ahead. In terms of barriers facing us right now, as with any other industry, is, you know, funding, making sure that the budget that the president puts forth or any kind of stimulus package that he puts forth has the needed funding in order to encourage high quality early care and education. The research behind early childhood education is clear in that good high quality programs that tend to also be more expensive are what makes the most difference. So making sure that we have the funding and the support from Congress is going to be the most important thing.
Kathy Patterson, I know you've been talking with early education advocates, not only here in Washington, but across the states. What are they most eager to see happen from a new Obama administration?
Well, I think first and foremost, as Nina said, is what's happening with the economy. Our state partners in capitals all over the country really want to see a recovery package that includes fiscal relief for states to help them continue to advocate for pre-K at the state level. So it's really important that some of that funding go to the states from the federal stimulus package so that our advocates can continue their push for state progress. But secondly, I think we're going to be looking for the what was promised in the campaign that David refers to. And if I recall, this was a $10 billion package for early childhood education. And we're going to be looking for that from the administration and wanting to be very helpful in shaping that.
Well, from every party, governors and others call themselves education leaders. They want to be on the right side of this issue. Would you say that there's bipartisan consensus on what has to happen next?
I think there is. When we saw a pre-K bill marked up in the House committee this year, we did get some Republican support. So I think that will be very, very helpful. But again, as Nina says, it's a real challenge in terms of the economic picture. But I think there is. Our governors are, you know, strong pre-K leaders are from both political parties. So there's a lot of bipartisan support for early education.
Yeah, I want to second that. I really think this really is the classic post-partisan issue. If you look at the great states, and the states have been the leaders in the pre-K movement and really in the early education movement for a good while. They come from red states and blue states because kids aren't red or blue.
Well, Nina, we saw earlier in the broadcast that the states are very interested in professional development for pre-K educators. Do you think policymakers at the national level understand the urgency of the issue and that there are policies or programs that need to be straightened out to help states meet these goals?
I sure hope so. And this was something that also came up on the last panel. The importance of high quality professional development cannot be emphasized enough. One of the things we notice in our centers is that whenever we bring new employees to our centers, regardless of their background, they need the professional development, the hands-on hand-holding that takes place at the center in order to excel at what they do with young children. So having access to the funding for professional development and also the research behind high-quality PD programs is very important. There's a lot out there. There's research being done, but that research is not always trickling down to the actual pre-K and child care centers, and that really needs to happen.
There are some provisions that were in the Higher Education Act that was approved this past year that will be very helpful in terms of pre-K teacher development, but it's another area for partnership between the new Congress and the new president in terms of how better to strengthen this workforce.
Well, what's the role down at the grassroots for people in our listening centers who are advocates in their local communities for pre-K education? What can they do to help the new president, the new Congress, grapple with these exciting and sometimes challenging pre-K proposals? David?
Well, I think it's important to get their act together and be clear and forceful and produce a unified message. Because it's an administration that cares a lot about this issue. My sense is that, Congress, there are people on both sides of the aisle who care a lot about this issue. But if you get a clear, concise message, if you get a children's lobby as strong as the AARP is for retired folks and is clear about what it wants, a lot's going to happen.
And we are moving in that direction, and more to come on that topic. But I do think it's really important also for all of our folks on the watching this broadcast that they stay in close touch with their members of Congress. It's never you can't invite your member of Congress too often to your local pre-K centers. And we have some new people coming into the Senate and the House, as well as the administration. They could use some education on what does good pre-K look like and how can federal policy be supportive.
Nina, you were on the inside. Does that grassroots activity actually penetrate the walls of the Department of Education?
Oh, absolutely. But in the case of child care and pre-K, I think a lot of the advocates and individuals on the ground working with children tend to be doing what they do best, which is interact with children and care and educate the children. They tend not to get too active at a political level. So what Kathy says is actually very true. Our company, KinderCare, has been trying very hard to mobilize our grassroots and our employees, center directors, to be more involved politically, invite members of Congress, local mayors, and what have you to our centers in order to make sure they see what we offer, that they understand what's at stake, and that they support us, whether financially or otherwise.
Thanks, guests, for all your insight, Kathy, Nina, and David. Thank you all for being with us today.